Hello, and a very warm welcome to LMT Royal YouTube channel.
The Duke of Sussex has made his first appearance since claims from his bombshell biography were published. Prince Harry appeared via video link from Los Angeles today to deliver the opening speech at a virtual global summit for his sustainable tourism project, Travelist. In the address, the royal urged the travel industry to build back better after COVID-19, saying it has a responsibility to reshape the way we travel. It is the first time Harry has been seen since the Sussex's biography, Finding Freedom, was serialized by The Times and The Sunday Times. The book lays bare the rift between Prince Harry, Meghan Markle, and the rest of the royal family. Harry spoke live from Los Angeles on Wednesday night to coincide with the start of the first summit session. A second session for viewers in AMA and the Americas will take place later today. He said in his opening speech, "Many of you joining us today rely on visitors for your livelihoods. Businesses are hitting significantly, and I've heard from some of you who are currently struggling to put food on your family's tables and make ends meet because there are no tourists and therefore no income. We need to build back, but we need to build back better. And that means there's a responsibility we cannot avoid or dismiss, for us to reshape this industry in a way that benefits everyone and everything for decades to come." He continued, "Before the pandemic unfolded, we witnessed more and more young people expressing an interest in authentic travel experiences and an ability to partake in trips that are greener, that allow them to support local communities, uphold heritage and protect destinations and cultures. This is the future of travel, and a future that Travelist is here to support and catalyze." Harry launched Travelist last autumn, branding it with leading brands Booking.com, Skyscanner TripAdvisor, Trip.com and Visor, and it now operates as an independent non-profit organization based in the UK. His appearance today comes amid shocking revelations from upcoming biography Finding Freedom, in which authors Omid Scobby and Carolyn Durand claim relations between the Sussexes and the Cambridges grew so bitter that by March the couples were barely speaking. Scobby and Durand, they have spoken to more than 100 sources, including close friends of Harry and Meghan's, royal aides and palace staff, past and present, with all the information in the book having at least two sources.
Travelist wants to help, and we are here to help, not just now, but in the long term as well. And this is what today is all about, to listen, learn, and hear directly from you, a group of inspiring leaders that are responding to the crisis of COVID-19 whilst making every effort to maintain and even accelerate the high standards of sustainability that you were pioneering before the pandemic. You're being part of this recovery and doing everything that you can to help communities around the world bounce back. It's not a shift in mission or a shift in values. This is your mission. These are your values. And I know it's not easy, but we all commend you. As many of you realized some time ago, destinations are under immense pressure. They're suffering significant damage. Communities are struggling. Habitats are being destroyed. And wildlife is being driven out, or worse, wiped out. We want to ensure that the industry that recovers is one that supports everyone fairly, one that protects destinations, better supports local communities, and is truly resilient. Before the pandemic unfolded, we witnessed more and more young people expressing an interest in authentic travel experiences and an ability to partake in trips that are greener, that allow them to support local communities, uphold heritage, and protect destinations and cultures. This is the future of travel, and a future that Travelist is here to support and catalyze. Over the years, I've encountered countless passionate, determined, and talented people around the world who are dedicated to the well-being of their local community. Their efforts ensure that tourism is the economic lifeblood of their region, while crucially protecting the local environment too. I am so excited for you to hear from some of them today, as you will realize you are far from being alone in this mission. Earlier this year, we hosted a summit in Scotland to begin exploring how we can drive toward a new model for tourism. What stood out was the need for a model that brings together all levels of the industry and actively champions the awe-inspiring work that's happening at the grassroots level. Travelist brings to the table some of the largest global brands in the industry, and the summit today is deliberately focused on local voices, your voices. The struggles we face are shouldered together, and the solutions must be too. This is how, surely, how we shape the future. There is a long road to recovery ahead. We all know this, but it is undoubtedly an opportunity for us to work together and build back better. As we approach the work ahead, let us not forget that our humanity is defined as much by what makes us unique: our cultures, our beliefs, experiences, and the environments around us, as it is by our shared values, our desire to make our communities better, our compassion for our friends, our family, and neighbors, and our hope for each of us to be safe and healthy, prosperous and happy. It is in how we honor and cultivate this balance between the unique and the shared that we build mutual respect, foster empathy, and advance economic progress in a way that is just to each other and the world around us. In this, we all have a role to play, especially those of us who can harness a platform to help. My hope for what happens after today is that all of us can come together online and off to realize these goals. So, enough from me, but thank you for your continued dedication to what is right and what is important. We are really looking forward to hearing how we at Travelist can work with you to put purpose together with profit, because the tourism industry and our planet can prosper when we work with communities at a grassroots level in reshaping the future. So thank you for your time. Thank you for your commitment.
Another analysis: the carbon footprint of eco warriors Prince Harry and Meghan could be 26 times higher than the average British. The ex-royals were seen on Friday in Beverly Hills in a Cadillac Escalade, said to be among the most polluting cars on the planet. But that motor, along with heat and carbon emissions from the 24,5 IOSQFT8 red Los Angeles mansion they are using, is only a fraction of their footprint, a study by former MP Norman Baker says. They generate 215 tonnes of carbon dioxide a year from flights, against the UK average of 8.3 tonnes for one person, it is claimed. They racked up at least 53 international flights in the 12 months to the end of January 2020, says the Lib Dem politician. Mr. Baker insisted, the only thing green about Prince Harry are his runners. The self-appointed eco-warrior, who likes to lecture everybody else on climate change, is in the top 1% of people on the planet for carbon emissions. You should cut the carbon and, if not, at least cut the crap. Harry spent $7,800 on a chopper trip to Birmingham in March last year, days before telling kids about climate change at Wembley. The Prince told them, climate change is a humanitarian issue and one where we've been far too slow in waking up to and acting on the damaging impact our living is having on the world. He said to pranksters in March that extreme action was needed to tackle climate change when he thought he was talking to campaigner Greta Thunberg. Meghan told the Girl Up Leadership Summit this week that young people must be in charge of the issue. The pair sparked claims of hypocrisy last summer when seen boarding a $26,000 private jet to stay in Elton John's French villa. The true scale of their emissions is likely to be even higher when including short connecting flights and car trips. Harry states he takes scheduled commercial flights 99% of the time. But of the 53 flights analysed, 18 were in private jets, which can be between 7 and 20 times worse for individual CO2 emissions than commercial flights. He says he offsets emissions by giving cash for trees. But Mr. Baker claims a typical tree absorbs 20 kilograms of carbon a year, means that Harry and Meghan will have to plant 10,700 fortified trees a year to make up for what they harm the environment, and that, of course, is not possible. Clearly, the above evidence shows that the Sussex family lied, always acting against the words they gave.
Please support growing LMT Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos are. Your support is the motivation for our to produce better videos. Stop. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.